Innovative concepts have the potential to set an organization apart, elevating it above its competitors. However, they can also become obstacles that hinder its progress. SpinLaunch appears to be facing the latter difficulty. Its cutting-edge centrifuge accelerator system, once celebrated as a groundbreaking method for space launches, has faced ongoing challenges over a long period of time. As a result, the company appears to be moving away from this approach and embracing more traditional, if reliable, technologies in an effort to revive its momentum. What lies ahead for SpinLaunch? Could this shift toward innovative strategies pave the way for success? Let's discuss more in today's episode of NR Studio. Founded by Jonathan Yaney in 2014 in Long Beach, California, SpinLaunch made its mark in the aerospace sector with a highly unconventional launch concept. Rather than relying on conventional rockets and chemical propulsion methods, the company designed an innovative kinetic launch system known as an accelerator, capable of launching payloads into space through the application of centrifugal force. The ultimate goal is to transform access to orbit by eliminating reliance on large fuel reserves, significantly reducing launch costs, reducing environmental impacts, and facilitating frequent and rapid launch sequences. The concept has attracted significant interest. Kinetic launch systems have been touted as a lighter, more cost-effective, and more sustainable alternative to existing technologies. Despite the excitement surrounding it, SpinLaunch's vision has faced significant technical challenges. Progress on the accelerator system has largely stalled since its most recent evaluation in 2022. There have been no significant updates or testing milestones. However, the company has recently indicated a shift in its strategic focus. In an unexpected turnaround, SpinLaunch has revealed a significant strategic shift. While the company is not abandoning accelerators altogether, it is emphasizing a more conventional approach. First, the creation of a new constellation of broadband satellites, alongside the use of conventional rockets for deployment. The newly established constellation, known as Meridian Space, has been under internal development since 2020. The satellites are compact, microscale payloads, each weighing about 70 kilograms, that are ingeniously designed in a unique six-petal flower configuration. This configuration increases stacking efficiency within the rocket's payload fairing, allowing SpinLaunch to target deployments of up to 250 satellites per launch, significantly surpassing the previous record of 143 satellites set by SpaceX Falcon 9 during the Transporter 1 mission in 2021. The company asserts that the Meridian satellite will usher in a breakthrough era of efficiency and performance improvements in satellite communications. The satellite is engineered to minimize the overall mass and volume of the satellite, simplify the deployment process, and lower the barriers to market entry. Additionally, its unique orbital configuration, characterized by repeated ground trajectories, will eliminate the need for complex 2D scanning antennas, facilitating the development of simpler and more cost-effective user terminals and ground stations. These aspirations remain very high. Eric Lee, president of Kongsberg Defense and Aerospace, or SpinLaunch's newly appointed partner, asserted that Meridian is poised to deliver far superior broadband capacity in its satellite constellation, surpassing current market offerings. David Wren, CEO of SpinLaunch, underlined that their collaboration with NanoAvionics, a leading European small satellite manufacturer, will provide a solid foundation for the rapid and assured scaling of their constellation. This tactical maneuver is supported by two key agreements. Initially, a $12 million grant from Kongsberg facilitated the development and initiation of operations for the constellation. Matthew Mejia, CFO and Chief Strategy Officer of SpinLaunch, commented that Kongsberg's investment signifies the maturity and potential of SpinLaunch's SATCOM system. He emphasized that their esteemed reputation and extensive global presence in defense and technology give us a tremendous advantage as we move forward. Additionally, SpinLaunch has awarded NanoAvionics a $135 million contract, designating them as the exclusive supplier for Meridian's satellite bus. The selection process was characterized as extremely thorough, with NanoAvionics selected for their proven track record in flight and the scalability of their platform's performance. However, this upcoming round marks a significant departure from the company's core identity. To put the constellation into orbit, SpinLaunch will initially rely on conventional rocket technology. While this may initially seem like a setback, the company emphasized that progress on the accelerator is ongoing. albeit at a more measured pace. The full version of the kinetic launcher is scheduled to be developed on Attic Island, Alaska, with a systematic approach to testing and refinement over time. SpinLaunch is currently targeting a 2026 timeframe for the first test launch of its innovative satellite system, which utilizes NanoAvionics In-Orbit Demonstrator, IOD, platform. If the test proves successful, the company anticipates launching its first fully operational mission in late 2027, with subsequent commercial deployments expected shortly thereafter. This transition may come as a disappointment to those initially attracted to SpinLaunch's bold vision. However, it also signals a pragmatic approach to ensuring sustainability and market penetration. Rather than waiting for an untested technological system to mature, the company is proactively building its presence in the competitive satellite communications sector, a field that continues to reward innovation, even when pursued through more traditional methods. The ultimate outcome of this new trajectory remains uncertain. However, there is no doubt that SpinLaunch is undergoing a transformation, with its future poised to be shaped by a combination of bold concepts and pragmatic implementation. These elements are fundamental components of SpinLaunch's current strategic roadmap. While undeniably ambitious, the plan has been met with a fair amount of skepticism. For starters, the proposed Meridian satellite constellation exists only in the realm of theory. While the company boldly claims efficiency and capacity, there is a lack of empirical evidence to support that the system can perform as intended under actual operational conditions. Building a high-speed, high-capacity satellite network at significant scale presents significant challenges, especially when attempting to compete directly with SpaceX's established Starlink system. Starlink currently dominates the industry, not only in terms of satellite count, but also in terms of demonstrated performance and broad global reach. Furthermore, SpinLaunch is not entering an empty arena. In addition to Starlink, the satellite internet market is witnessing significant entry of leading competitors. Platforms such as OneWeb, Amazon's recently introduced Project Kuiper, and established systems such as GPS each have their own strengths and established market positions. This intensifies the challenges that SpinLaunch faces in establishing a differentiated competitive position. Furthermore, we must address the issue of launch methodology. The company's approach of initially using conventional rockets, followed by a shift to its basic kinetic accelerator system, presents significant design and logistical hurdles. The satellites are expected to require significant changes to adapt to two fundamentally different launch architectures. Such inconsistencies could hinder progress in production schedules, integration, and deployment. Most significantly, the transition to conventional rockets represents a potential divergence or even retreat from SpinLaunch's fundamental vision. The accelerators were envisioned as a bold alternative to traditional rocket propulsion, with the goal of transforming access to space. Using the very systems they want to replace could be seen as an admission of failure. While the company says the accelerator is still in development, there is no firm timeline for its return or any guarantee of its future viability. Should SpinLaunch decide to depend on rockets for deployment, SpaceX would inherently present itself as the most rational choice of provider. Its unparalleled launch frequency, adaptable manifest options, and competitive rideshare pricing make it exceptionally beneficial for small satellite operators. However, by pursuing this strategy, SpinLaunch would find itself relying on the very entity it seeks to contest with Meridian Space. Central to SpinLaunch's obstacles is the inherent complexity of its kinetic accelerator system. Although the concept is revolutionary, it presents a myriad of significant technical and logistical challenges that remain unresolved. The primary and most apparent obstacle is physiological in nature. The accelerator must produce sufficient force to propel a payload through Earth's dense atmosphere and achieve orbital velocity. In order to attain orbit, a payload is required to ascend to an elevation of approximately 300 kilometers while reaching a velocity of around 25,000 kilometers per hour. Nonetheless, in the course of testing conducted in 2021 and 2022, SpinLaunch executed merely 10 suborbital flights, with the peak altitude reaching approximately 10 kilometers and a maximum velocity of around 1,600 kilometers per hour. Currently insufficient to meet orbital requirements, addressing this deficit necessitates the development of a significantly larger accelerator system engineered to withstand far more intense launch forces. The second concern pertains to the intrinsic risk of damage to payloads during the launch phase. The accelerator operates under intense centrifugal force, which, despite being energy efficient in certain aspects, imposes significant stress on the object being launched. The system is required to function within a vacuum environment, necessitating that payloads withstand a sudden transition from a vacuum chamber to atmospheric pressure upon egress, a shift that poses a significant risk of structural damage. These parameters render the system ill-suited for a variety of sensitive instruments, especially those intended for scientific or commercial applications. A further significant constraint is that the present system is exclusively compatible with solid fuel payloads. In contrast, the majority of contemporary spacefaring vehicles employ liquid fuel propulsion systems due to their unparalleled versatility and efficiency. This considerably limits the prospective market for SpinLaunch, given that most future payload designs favor liquid fuel configurations for their launch vehicles. Compounding these technical obstacles is the absence of community backing and the necessary infrastructure. SpinLaunch has successfully constructed two suborbital accelerators, one with a diameter of 133 meters in New Mexico and a smaller counterpart in California. However, the company has encountered obstacles in its pursuit of a site for an orbital scale facility. The proposed system, with a diameter of 100 meters, has encountered resistance in various regions, notably in Hawaii and certain areas of Alaska. The company recently struck a deal with Ella Corporation to build a facility on Attic Island, a remote location in Alaska, which poses its own unique logistical challenges. Unfortunately, I must admit that financial constraints are also a significant concern. Its recent 2023 fundraising round only raised $11.5 million, well short of its $25 million target, and a far cry from the $71 million raised in 2022. This reduced capital is unlikely to be enough to support the expansion of operations, especially given the enormous costs involved in large-scale infrastructure development and technology upgrades. Ultimately, the launch industry as a whole continues to show remarkable levels of underdevelopment. Established aerospace companies, spearheaded by SpaceX, have maintained an impressive presence through unmatched launch frequency, innovative reusability, and incredible cost-effectiveness. In 2024, SpaceX conducted more than 100 launches, while its rideshare initiative provides small satellite operators with economical access to orbital deployments. At the same time, other industry competitors such as Blue Origin, with its New Glenn rocket, ULA with its Vulcan, and Rocket Lab with its Neutron, are making significant strides in developing advanced reusable systems. In this context, despite its innovative approach, SpinLaunch faces a daunting challenge in demonstrating that its system is beyond a mere visionary concept. SpinLaunch is at a significant crossroads. Its bold transition to a satellite constellation represents a strong determination to maintain relevance in the ever-evolving and highly competitive space sector. However, it underscores a departure from the company's original kinetic launch concept. The conceptual framework that shaped its identity, coupled with technical challenges and slow progress on its accelerator system, have forced SpinLaunch to reevaluate its strategy. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.